What is up, Ludi Bros Army? It is your boy, Big Bro Lamar Ludi, coming to you with a new deck profile today. I'm really excited to bring this deck profile to you guys. I was excited when I found out this leader was coming. I couldn't wait to build the deck and build something around it. And I finally was able to get the cards and put it all together. I'm bringing you the Topo Candidate of Destruction deck. So I went ahead and I went mono yellow with this deck. I had a couple builds of it, and this is the one that I decided to settle on. So let's go ahead and let's jump right into the deck list. We're gonna start off with the leader. Here he is. This is what he's looking like. Topo's got his fists up. He's ready for action. Auto, when this card attacks, you're gonna draw one card. Now he has a very interesting awakening that's gonna be working with the new Unison cards that were also released. So for him to awaken, you can either awaken when your life's at four or less, or if you have a yellow Unison card with a specified cost of two in play. You may choose up to two of your energy, switch them to active mode, then choose two cards in your life and add them to your hand until you have six life left and flip this card over. So you'll be awakening turn two. Normally I've been able to awaken turn two with this deck, and that's where it really takes off because he'll awaken and he'll become Topo Candidate of Destruction. Auto, when this card attacks, you're gonna draw one card, so that's pretty standard. But let's take a close look at the permanent. If you have a yellow Unison card with a specified cost of two in play, when a player plays a battle card, that player cannot play battle cards for the turn. So this effect right here is what made me want to build the deck. To me, it comes out to a very slow down the pace of the game, grind them out style of play that can really lead to some big plays later on, because you're gonna have lots a chance to ramp up lots of energy. So let's go ahead and take a close look at the deck. So this is the Unison card that I decided to put in here, the Vegeta Unison of Fury. This Unison card came along with the expansion set, the Universe 11 expansion set that recently came out. I went ahead and did a pack opening for that, so you can go ahead and check out what other cards you get in the set. Most of the cards I did use here, but there was a couple that I didn't use in this final variation of the deck, and you can check out that video to see what those were. But let's look at Vegeta Unison of Fury. So these are the new Unison cards. They don't have any combo power. They have their own special area on the playing field that you're going to be able to put them into. Let's see what this one does and how he can work alongside the leader. So he's got a specified cost of two. Activate main once per turn. You can choose this card or one of your battle cards. You'll switch it to rest mode and you'll add a marker back onto this card. If you take away one marker, activate main, your opponent can't attack with battle cards with energy costs greater than their current energy until the end of their next turn. Or his big activate main, if you take away three markers, you'll choose up to one of your opponent's energy, switch it to rest mode, then this card gets plus 5,000 power, double strike, and dual attack for the turn. So when you're finally ready to go for game, you can go ahead and set it up where your Unison card is able to do some attacks. Now, remember the Awakened Topo's effect. If you have a yellow Unison card with a specified cost of two in play, when a player plays a battle card, that player cannot play battle cards for the turn. So we want to really slow down the battle. We want to make sure that we have some Unison markers on Vegeta Unison of Fury, and we want to keep him on board as much as possible. So with that being the strategy, let's go ahead and look at some of the cards that went ahead and went into the deck. Now, I have a lot of counters in this deck. I'm running a lot of counters to go ahead and play Protect the Unison card. The first being Flying Nimbus, which is probably one of the best counters for yellow. So Flying Nimbus is effect, counter, attack. You'll negate the attack. Then you may place one yellow card in your hand in the drop area. If you do so, your opponent can only attack one more time with battle cards for the duration of the turn. So you can really slow down your opponent's plays. You can slow down an aggressive opponent. We're running four copies of this. We're running two copies of Restrain. Another counter attack, if your leader card is yellow, you can negate the attack, then choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards with energy cost of one or less and switch it to rest. So if they happen to have a one drop out there, you're able to switch that to rest mode. The permanent for this card is useful here though. If this card is in your drop area, you can activate it by paying its energy cost and removing it and one yellow card in your hand from the game. So you can essentially use Restrain. I have two copies here, but you can essentially use it four times based off that secondary permanent effect. We're also running two times magic. Counter, attack, your leader card is yellow. You're gonna negate the attack. Then you choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards in rest mode, ignoring barrier. It can't switch to active mode until the start of your next turn. So you're gonna be able to slow down your opponent. They'll swing with the card. It's gonna go into rest mode. Or if they have something that's already tapped, you can freeze it out for a turn and they're not gonna be able to use it again. Also, this counter has a sparking five. where if you have five cards in your drop area, you can activate this counter by taking a card from your life instead of tapping the energy. So just a little bit more flexibility when it comes to the counter. So we really want to protect our unison card, because when your opponent goes to swing at this unison card, based on how it's designed, you remove markers from it. And you need to have a unison card in play in order for your leader's permanent effect to take effect. Our last counter play here out of the extra cards is Spirit Fist. Now, I thought I like Spirit Fist over Crusher Ball because of the activate battle. First off, let's look at the counter play. When the battle card is played, you may choose it and switch it to rest mode. So you're going to be able to tap their card when they go ahead and play it. But it has an activate battle too, so it's an extra little effect that Crusher Ball doesn't have. If your leader card is Universe 11, which ours is, and it's your turn, so this is only on your turn, you'll choose up to one of your leader cards, up to one of your yellow unison cards with a specified cost of 2, and it's going to get plus 10,000 power for the turn. So if you do go with your Vegeta Unison of Fury and you decide to take off the three markers, he's going to go up to 20,000. If you have a Spirit Fist, he can go all the way up to 30,000. And this is for the turn. So both of those attacks off of that dual attack will be 30,000. So we have four Spirit Fists here. And those are all of our extra cards that we're running in the deck. So four Nimbus, four Spirit Fists, 2 and 2 for Restrain and Time's Magic. Starting with one of the new battle cards that came in the expansion set, cost roll the Slash Striker. Auto, when you play this card, look it up to 5 cards from the top of your deck. Choose up to 1 yellow unison card with a specified cost of 2, or up to 1 yellow Universe 11 card with an energy cost of 4 or less among them, and you're going to add it to your hand, then you'll shuffle your deck. So this is going to be your searcher. You're going to be able to search out your unison card or any of the other Universe 11 cards that we have in the deck as we continue to go through the deck. So this can kind of be like a little starting point for you. Now, he also has an auto that works with Vegeta Unison of Fury. When this card is switched to rest mode by one of your skills, choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards with an energy cost of 4 or less, and you'll switch that to rest mode. So once again, you can activate Vegeta Unison of Fury's effect to choose this card or one of your battle cards, switch it to rest. You'll put the marker on him. If you choose cost roll to switch to rest mode, then you can choose one of your opponent's battle cards and switch that to rest mode. So we see a nice little manipulation of your opponent's field. Let's come down here to Dispo the Flash Striker. Now, I really like this card in the deck because of his activate main. If you have a yellow unison card with a specified cost of 2 in play and you have no battle cards in play, you can play this card from your hand. So he's coming out for free. I really think that with this deck and the strategy that I tried to employ here was getting bodies on board during my opponent's turn, or using this Dispo the Flash Striker, which isn't going to tap my energy, and that's going to leave my energy standing for all these extra cards that I need to play in order to protect my unison card and really slow down and grind out the game. So we're going to run 4 of these. He's critical, 1500, and he's coming out turn 2. The super combo that I chose for this deck was the Key Bomb Support Coquette. When you combo this card for leader cards Universe 11 and you have 5 or less life, based off of our leader's awakening, then we're going to see that he's already going to be coming down to 6 for sure, because you're going to have to add cards to your hand until you have 6 life left. So reaching that requirement of 5 lives is very easy with this deck. So she's going to come in as the super combo. We'll draw 1, she'll gain the 10. I'm running 4 Destructive Occupation Frieza. Now, the reason for this card, I'm never going to hard cast it for 3. I'm always going to combo with it during my opponent's turn. So that way I can get him on board and he will not count against, he won't count against me with that permanent of Topo Cannon of Destruction when he's awakened, of bringing out just 1 battle card per turn. So at the end of the battle, if you combo with this card from your hand, if your leader card is yellow, you're going to play this card in rest mode. So I'm always using it defensively, fighting off my opponent to then play this card out, and I've got an extra body on board. So essentially, let's see how this play could develop out. Turn 2, I'll tap the 2 energy to bring out the unison. I'll awaken, restanding those 2 energy. I'll play my Dispo for free during my turn. I've now met that requirement of playing out the 1 card, and then on my opponent's turn I can play my Destructive Occupation Frieza defensively, fighting off their attack and leaving my energy still standing. None of that has cost me anything except for the 1 energy during my opponent's turn. So I mean, for a 15k body that I can get on board very simply during their turn, and then be very aggressive with him when it comes back to my turn. I'm running four Justice Blast. Now, the reason for this card is actually, you know, it's come in very well for me because I'm not using my energy to play out the cards. So I'm going to have the three yellow energy that I'm going to need to go ahead and use the second or the first activate main. If your leader card is yellow, choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards in rest mode, ignoring barrier, negate a skill for the duration of the turn, then KO it. Justice Blast can handle just about anything, you know, well, basically, yes, it can handle anything in the game for just three energy. And you're going to be able to get, you know, three energy simply because you're slowing down the game. We're going to slow it down to a grind them out game. Your opponent's going to go try to make their plays. You'll be able to defend with your counters. And then you can easily wipe out what they've got on the board with Justice Blast. So we're going to run four copies of this. We're going to skip over Son Goku and come over to Belmod. Now it's another counter play and a counter attack. Permanent though, I want to look at that first. During your opponent's turn, if you have a yellow unison card with a specified cost of two in play, you're going to reduce the energy cost of this card in your hand by two. So he's going to come down to just two energy. Now you should have two energy standing during your opponent's turn to go ahead and get this guy out on the field. So counter play, the battle card being played is played in rest mode, then play this card, or you can counter attack. And you can negate the attack, play this card, then choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards and negate its skills for the turn. So he's very much like a toolbox card. You can use him to stop their plays, to put their cards in rest mode, or you can negate attacks with him. You're going to get a 20k body on board. He's universe 11, so even if he ends up in your drop area, that's okay based off a little hidden tech that I added into the deck that we're going to see later on. Now, I think that this Topo Justice Forsaken is a very good card in this deck because of the fact that you will get, you know, you're going to get high amounts of energy. And he's going to come out. He's a triple striking monster with 30,000 attack. Topo Justice Forsaken. Auto, when you play this card, choose all of your opponent's battle cards, ignoring barrier, switch them to rest mode, then negate their skills for the turn. So we're seeing with this deck that we're able to put a lot of things in rest. We're able to negate a lot of skills. Auto, when this card is placed in the drop area from the battle area by a skill, or if it's KO'd, you're going to be able to draw two cards. So even though you're committing the five energy to him, you're going to be able to recur back some of your cards once he goes to the drop area. And, you know, I really do feel that this card is very good in this deck because you're going to get high amounts of energy, you're going to slow down your opponent, and you'll be able to pull this out, and you'll most likely still have other bodies on board when you go to do that. Okay, so now we've got a little yellow package here. Son Goku, Path to Greatness, and Height of Mastery, Son Goku. This is a yellow deck, so we're going to go ahead and find space for this. Son Goku, Path to Greatness, he's got barrier. He's got 19K. You got to commit three energy to him, but that's fine. He also has swap eight. So for four yellow energy, you'll be able to swap him into a Goku's Lineage card with an energy cost of eight. Auto, when you play this card, choose up to one of your opponent's battle cards. You're going to switch it to rest mode and draw one. And then Height of Mastery, he has Deflect, he has Triple Strike, he has Dual Attack. When you play this card with Swap, choose up to a total of three of your opponent's battle cards or energy, ignoring Barrier, and you'll switch them to rest mode. So you'll be able to play him out. You know, if he doesn't fall victim to a denial of hope or anything like that, then he'll be on board with his barrier. And then on the next turn, you tap the four energy, and here comes Height of Mastery, triple striking, dual attack, 35,000. And I mean, he's going to come in. He's going to choose three of your opponent's battle cards or energy, ignoring barrier, switch them to rest mode, and you're going for game. So this is a yellow deck. We're going to find space for the Height of Mastery package. Now, my one little extra boss card that I've squeezed into the deck here is Jiren, Universe's Strongest. He has Deflect, so he's unaffected by counterplay skills. He's got Quadruple Strike, so he's going to be taking four lives. Permanent, when there are nine or more Universe 11 in your drop area, you're going to reduce the energy cost of this card in your hand by six. And then another permanent, during battles when this card attacks, your opponent may not activate counter or blocker. So I'm telling you, with this deck and the grind 'em out style that you have to play, you will get to six energy. The reason why I chose the Key Bomb Support Coquette for my super combo instead of any of the multicolored super combos was because she's Universe 11. So she's going to help fuel us up to get to the requirement of the nine or more Universe 11s in the drop area. This game, if this card comes out, you're going to be swinging for game, you know, essentially, because it can take that, you know, four damage with one attack, and he's 40k. So that's it for this deck. I do want to show one more thing here. We can go ahead and we can check out the price. The deck price is coming in at $38.38. We can see here that the Vegeta Unison of Fury for four copies is roughly about $13. You can buy one of the little expansion sets for about $14. That's going to come with two, and you're going to get all the cards in that. Like I said, I did a pack opening for that, so you can go check out the other cards that were in there. And we can see that the deck's pretty reasonable to go ahead and put together. You can go ahead and put this together. I really have been having a lot of fun playing this deck. I've been getting a lot of wins running this deck. It's a slow them down, grind them out build. And you're coming in with High to Mastery. You're coming in with that surprising Jiren that can go ahead and swing. You know, someone's at four lives and they're thinking they're safe. And then you just drop that guy on them, turn six. And you're going to get to the six energy because you're going to really slow down the game and be able to hit him with that. So I hope you guys like this deck profile for Topo Candidate of Destruction. If you did, go ahead, give me a thumbs up. Make sure you're subscribed. Remember, we're doing pretty well here. We're growing the channel, and we can only do that with your support. So please share this video if you liked it, and go ahead, hit that thumbs up button. Make sure you have the notification bell turned on, and we will see you guys next time.